Hello, Martis. My name is Animegro, and welcome to Phoenix Wright Ace Attorney Justice Sprawl. Or Phoenix Wright 2. Just to make it shorter, so it'll be Phoenix Wright Justice Sprawl. So, this is the new game, next game I'm going to play in the Phoenix Wright series. Because I had to know what's going to happen into do business. So let's just begin with the new game, The Lost Turnabout. Okay. This case name, the rock music. How did you get through this mess? That's far enough. You can't run forever, Mr. Phoenix Wright. Oh, the judge! Ah! What have you done wrong? I cannot allow you to go on like this! But I used to sleep at the first attorney! Silence! You're no longer worthy for your title! It was a dream, of course. Judge isn't that big or scary. Oh, we get to see Phoenix in his pool buddy. Oh, what a nightmare. And I bet it was this ringtone that caused it. I really shouldn't be dozing off right before a trial starts anyway. Beep. Huh? Looks like they hung up. Oh, good, they finally found it. Talk about the close call. I hate to do this to you, but... It's not the personal, Mr. Attorney. It's not personal, Mr. Attorney. Sorry. A few minutes later, the District Court defended lobby number one. My head is dropping. Why does it feel so foggy in there? Good morning! Good morning. What's wrong? You don't look well. You people are the best. People are the best first thing in the morning. Where's the fighting spirit? Sorry, but can you please turn the sirens down? Sirens down? My head sort of hurts. Where's it at? Am I in trouble or something? Huh? Trouble? Wait, never mind. You're a policewoman, right? I thought maybe I've done something wrong. What are you talking about? I'm the one in trouble. What? I'm placing my life in your hands today, Mr. Phoenix Wright. Life in my hands? You promised me. You said you would prove that I was not guilty. Yes, but I thought all hope was lost when all the other lawyers had laughed me off. Leave it to me, you said. You're the one and only Phoenix Wright came to say today. Just like that, I was moved to tears, sir. I will never forget what you're doing for me, ever. What is this group babbling about? Actually, I really love to watch court proceedings. And I always root for you to win. When I'm off duty, I'd like to come here and... What's wrong? You've been acting strange and... You've been acting strange, really strange, and you keep staring at me. You're making me kind of nervous, sir. Sorry. I'm afraid to ask, but here goes. So, this might sound bad, but, who are you? What? Mr. Wright, how could you say that? How could you do this? To the frail heart of a girl about to go to garden trail. You're absolutely horrible. No, I didn't mean it like that. Is this how a defense attorney treats his clients, sir? I can't believe this. Oh, it's just, well, you think you have the wrong person. I am, who am I? Am I drawing, why am I drawing a blank? The trial will begin.
The trial will begin shortly. Will the defendant and the lawyer please proceed to the court immediately?
The trial's about to start. I'm calling you a new trial, okay? I guess I must have amnesia. Let's see, what can I piece together? From our conversation, I can safely say that I'm probably up the fist attorney. And that girl, I said I did prove her not guilty. I can't believe I made such an irresponsible promise. Someone who is! Time, but this is just a bad dream. Why do I get the feeling this is one dream I won't be walking up from? Oh, Mr. Payne is here! Court is now in session for the trial of Maggie Bird.
The prosecution is ready, Your Honor!
Sorry. What is it, Mr. Wright? Are you talking to me? Do you see any other defense attorneys here? I guess not. Ugh. No, then, are you ready?
Yes, I'm ready.
I guess I should say yes for now. Are you ready, Mr. Wright?
Yes, Your Honor.
Wait a sec. If your life is in my hands, I should really do the responsible thing. Actually, you see, Your Honor, my memory is kind of... The court will not hear the defense excuses. Because the defendant is a member of the police, this case is under great scrutiny. Therefore, we must make it this trial fair but swift. I believe I had told you this before. I hope you're not telling me you've forgotten. Actually, I did. Mr. Payne, your opening statement, please.
Yes, Your Honor. I'm sure you are well aware the defendant is accused for killing your lover. What's worse, your lover was a fellow police officer.
A policeman? You did what, the policeman?
It was me! And besides, Dustin and I, we weren't lovers like that. In any case, the prosecution will prove the guilty parties, no other than the defendant.
Very well. Mr. Payne, please call your first witness.
It's been a while, Mr. Wright. Let's see what you learned since last time.
Have you seen my courts at done and have victory of all of them?
I want you to show any mercy this time, rookie.
Okay, and who are you again?
Please bring Detective Gomes to the stand. Here we go. Don't let me down, Mr. Wright.
Nowhere to hide. I'm so dead.
Hey, comes you. With this, please state your name and occupation.
My name is Dick Gumshoe, sir. I'm the detective in charge of homicides down at the precinct, sir.
You don't look very well, detective.
Well, sir, the defendant, she works under me, so you know.
You work under that detective?
Yes, sir. And then while I was a trainee, he was always watching over for me, sir. He's such a wonderful guy, sir. Never forget what he done for me.
Okay, come on, I believe you.
Detective Gumshoe, please describe for us the details of this murder.
Yes, sir. It happened to the park near headquarters, Exposed Park. The victim was the one of the local cops, Dusty Prince. He was pushed down from the benches on the upper path, sir. The ladder beat his body up and stabbed his neck.
The details are listed in a report that was distributed yesterday.
Oh yes, the autopsy report, correct? Why do you not remember getting a copy? I see everything is in order here. Even the estimated time of the death is unusually well documented.
The victim watched up from the impact of the landing, sir. The results of the autopsy confirmed the time of death.
If I may, Your Honor, the prosecution would like to submit the photograph.
Very well.
Very well, the court accepts it with the evidence. Cry for the one added to the court report.
Northerner, I recall that at yesterday's preliminary hearing, a very important piece of evidence was brought to our court.
Yes, Your Honor.
Yes, sir.
Yes, I guess. Mr. Wright, is your head on the right today? There was a very crucial piece of evidence found under Victor's body. Was there?
Have you lost your mind?
Well, actually, it's just nerves. Give me a second.
What? How can you talk like such an amateur? I thought you were a pro, sir.
All right, sir. I will help you to rest. At a time like this, maybe you ought to take a glance at the court record.
Court record?
Yep, either evidence. Info about evidence and people involved in this case are listed here. So you can look at the court record by touching the court record button.
The court record button? You really know what you're talking about, huh?
It's the matter of a cop, right? Just think, I could totally be a legal aid, he said.
Mr. Wright, yes, Your Honor.
Court is in session, so save your shit for later.
Sorry, Your Honor.
Well, I guess I'd better check the court record and see what I can find.
The glasses here, dust is a Thompson report, okay, cell phone, crime photo, check, okay, it's that, and then my badge, okay, what was it again, the court record button,
alright Mr. Wright, let's see if your notes are in order. What was the piece of evidence found on the victim's body?
It was the glasses.
That's simple, Your Honor.
A broken pair of glasses.
That's right.
The victim grabbed the criminal's glasses as he was being shoved in, sir, and held it as he fell.
Hey, why are you giving me the evil eye?
Those glasses you're wearing.
Yes, this is my spare pair, but these glasses were found at the scene of crime. It's not mine, I swear, sir.
You sure about that?
Look, it was coincidence that on the same day you actually stepped on mine.
A coincidence, she says?
Your Honor, I have further evidence to present.
Oh, you have more?
This is evidence is very decisive.
Very well. Let's hear from our witness about this evidence.
Wait, I have to check the court. Oh, we can look at the professor.
Maggie Bird, that's my client. And there's the victim, Dustin Prince. Winston, pain again. Sorry. And Gumshoe.
There's a even more incriminating than the glasses under the victim's body, sir. During his date, the victim was pushed from the bench area, but he managed to write the culprit's name on the ground when he landed.
I forgot the name already. It was Maggie, but okay, the name is spelled wrong, so that's a contradiction.
I don't like saying it, but it was clear the defendant's name, Maggie, sir. With this piece of evidence and the glasses, it's hard to say she's not a culprit.
This is a picture. This is a picture of the writing, Your Honor.
Why, this is. Yes, you can see the name is clearly written here.
The prosecution would like to submit the picture.
Understood. The court is accepted into evidence.
As if the glasses alone didn't make you look suspicious. The victim even wrote your name clearly as clear stay on the ground.
But I told you, these glasses aren't mine.
How do you explain this dying message?
It's a culprit. It's not guilty, sir.
Mr. Wright, you may cross-examine the witness.
Cross-examine? That's it. I can't deny you.
Sure, but what am I supposed to do?
What? This isn't like you at all. Normally this is part where you get in the witness faces.
Get in their faces and do what?
I guess there's no way around it. Okay, I'm going to lend you a hand. The prosecutors witness all the high things from the court, which means they lie from time to time.
Lie? But isn't that detective your superior?
Well, even if they don't mean to lie, sometimes people just remember things wrong.
like the detective. He does sort of look like a scatterbrain. Oh my god.
It doesn't matter. Either way, it's bad for us, sir. That's why when you question witnesses, you have to find out the exposure lies.
Mr. Wright, do you cross examination, please?
Yes, Honor. Talk about trial by fire. It costs nothing. As long as they can expose the lies, we should be alright.
Ooh, new bar! No, it's no 5 exclamation marks, nor is a whole bar.
Oh yes, you can press the profile now.
Objection!
Objection!
What is it? What was come over me? Without thinking, I just spurred up objection. And I yelled it over from a long finger outstretched and ready to take my opponent.
What a rush!
He's high!
Sorry.
The thing comes you.
You're talking to me, pal?
Please take the defendant's name for me.
Objection! What are you talking about? Prove it is pure exercise, Mr. Wright.
You will see, this is where a crucial line of questioning. Actually, Miss Bain, you can answer. The defendant's name, if you please.
What is this ridiculous question coming from? The defendant's name, same name is Maggie Bird.
I think someone needs to check the court report.
What? It says right here that is Maggie Burr!
It looks like the bird caught the cat snapping.
What's going on? What's going on here?
I have no idea, sir. Either, sir.
As you can see, the victim did indeed leave a name Maggie. However, the defendant's name is actually spelled Maggie.
Maggie.
But it's a blatant contradiction of facts.
Ooh!
How about that? I didn't notice.
But maybe the victim didn't know how to spell her name correctly.
May I remind you, it was you who said the defendant is confused for killing her lover. If they were true lovers, it would be possible for him to have not known her name.
No!
I bet Pain is going to be just one trial, then he's going to disappear again.
This is very true. Mr. Pain?
Yes, Your Honor?
Are you certain that the defendant and the victim, the prince, were in fact lovers?
Yes, I'm quite certain, sir. My Honor, they were known a couple in the police force.
Detective Gumshoe, please testify for the court the relationship between the victim and the defendant.
Yes, sir.
Officer Prince and Officer Bird have been going out for half a year. It's not like they were even talking about marriage. The day of the incident just happened to be the victim's birthday, sir.
Officer Bird had gotten Officer Prince a present. It was something she had gotten over 2 months ago. I should know, because she came to me to ask what she should get for him.
Oh, those two sound like they were very close.
Nevertheless, tragedy struck.
Yes, I see. You may cross examine the witness, Mr. Wright.
Officer Prince and they're going on for half a year. It sounded like they were even talking about marriage. The day of the incident was happened to be the victim's birthday, sir. Officer present.
You seem to know a lot about the defendant.
Well, that's because I'm her boss. I got a watch out from her subordinates.
But even if what she was going to give a present, isn't that going to be too far?
Hey, pal, watch what you say. I know everything that happens under me. If someone so much as scratches there,
I really don't need to know that much.
Mr. Wright, please refrain from bashing the witness. I agree. Even if this witness has crush on the defendant, that should not be the point of discussion at this point in time.
Well, wait a second. Why are we talking about this? It's all your fault, pal. You're guilty, guilty, guilty. I should have arrested you.
I think the good detective is about done here. Over 2 months ago?
Yep, she was a very concentrated woman, pal.
So, what was this birthday present?
She got him a glove.
A single glove? Why would she give him one?
Actually, Your Honor, the glove is in question is a baseball glove.
Oh, I see, a baseball glove.
Officer Marshall was a huge baseball fan.
Officer
Prince!
I said Marshall right away. Yes, no, I believe you said her present was something she had gotten over 2 months ago.
Yeah.
Are you saying she went out and bought the glove over 2 months ago?
Nah, nothing like that, pal.
Then what is it like?
She ordered it. It was custom made.
Custom made? The glove was custom made?
Yep, that's what I said.
So the glove was custom made.
Your Honor, I really don't see how this glove is related to this case.
Yes, it would seem that it's little relevance. What do you think, Mr. Wright? Do you think this glove is relevant to this case?
Of course, is this question I got to answer yes. I don't know where this will lead me, but
of course it is relevant. That glove is the key of this whole case.
Yes, perfect to the max. Now this is the mystery right now. Yes, I'm happy you're back, sir. I was wondering how long it would take. This is great.
Pressing people. It feels like I've done this before. As if I used to do this to squish information from even the most tight-lipped people. Very well. If you are not convinced, then let's hear some more about this matter.
Actually, I brought a glove with me today.
And? Why didn't you say so earlier? Hurry and show the glove to our court.
Well, I didn't think it had to do anything with this case.
Looks like bananas. No, I want bananas. I go to get it later.
Anyway, this is it, sir.
Is this a rather... It's a rather yellow, isn't it? Bananas. I got hungry all of a sudden.
Officer Prince really liked the color yellow.
And that's why you had to special order it?
Yep, that's right. That, one other reason.
I think this court has heard enough. It is clear that the victim and the defendant were involved with each other.
Yes, that's correct, Your Honor.
No, if this is true, then it brings up an important question. Was the name Maggie really written by the victim?
I see a point, Your Honor. Detective Gum, Shoe, please tell the court a little more about the name on the ground.
Yes, sir. We first looked at the interim handwriting, sir. Unfortunately, we couldn't confirm it was the victim's handwriting. Next, we checked the victim's point finger. We found out that there was a scent trapped under the victim's fingernails. There was also scratches on the skin that were caused by him writing on the ground. From this, we could confirm that the victim wrote this name with his right hand.
Yes, a perfectly logical conclusion. No, then, Mr. Wright, you may cross-examine the witness. Thank you, Your Honor. Now I have to check the glove. He said he wrote with his right hand, but a birthday present from Maggie to the victim, it was custom-made.
Are there more information?
Oh. Wait. Profiles. Are you absolutely sure?
I believe in the power of science.
I wonder if my evidence is solid enough to counter this. Listening to this, you should listen to this. You would like there was only one conclusion, that the name was definitely written by the victim.
But don't you think this, that would be really strange, sir? Sir, you just really want to mess with this right hand. Do you think I would have gone through with that much trouble to get this present?
The present? What about it? Wait. Okay. The glove was for right hand, and you had a ball on the right, left, so...
He's a left-handed!
But it isn't... I don't have enough...
I know that much on baseball.
So in there you can confirm it.
Hey, don't look at me down at us! I told you, we're not a bunch of simpletons, pal. Everyone knows you can find out everything you want to with scientific investigation.
I had never heard of that before.
Me either!
Nor I.
I never heard anything like that in a police academy, sir.
Okay, so I made it up anyway. Anyway.
But you had Emma just last year for them? Next, we check the witness finger pointer.
His pointer finger? You know, the one you're always pointing and waving around in people's faces.
don't tell me it bothers you.
Every time you do it, I have a mini heart attack. It's like you're trying to kill me, pal.
In any case, you examined the witness index finger, correct?
Yeah, we figured there should be something within this finger which you're written as that.
And those results? Okay. Objection! Oh. Even though they didn't say it was for left-handed people. Okay. There you go, take a look at this.
That's the glove, right?
Could you tell the court what is so special about this glove?
That's what's special? Never really thought about it, but it's really yellow. And that's about it.
Yes, it's really yellow, but this is one of his qualities. Huh?
Huh? That's another reason why it's special.
And what would that be?
It's very simple. This glove is made for a left-handed person. Left-handed?
You're absolutely right. This glove is made for to be worn on the right hand.
That's why it had to be custom made.
I've never seen a bright yellow left-hander's glove for sale, have you?
No.
So, detective, which hand did the victim use to write the name with it again?
That's easy. Look, it's obvious from this picture. There was this. Wait a second.
Don't forget the victim was left-handed.
Are you object?
Overruled. Mr. Wright, I would like to know what your line of reasoning more proves.
There's only one conclusion that can be drawn. A left-handed person could have not written a message with his right hand.
Therefore, the person who wrote the name Maggie could not have been the victim.
But if you're really good with the right hand, then you can write it there too.
Well, when you think about it that way, then yes. It is not possible that this name was written by the victim herself. Himself.
Miss Baggis.
No. No, it's not possible!
Mr. Payne.
Yes, Your Honor.
The evidence the prosecution has presented have failed to prove the defendant's guilt. In fact, I believe you have proven her to be innocent.
No! Alright, you did it, Miss Wright. Phew, I feel like I can breathe again.
It seems that we have reached a conclusion. You did a fine job once again, Mr. Wright.
Me, Your Honor?
Well, thank you, sir.
See, you got complimented by a judge again. You're really good. And that's why you can't give up being a lawyer, sir.
Are you okay? I'm more than ready to retire.
I will now announce my verdict. This court finds the defendant, Maggie, heard?
No, not yet, Joe! You're there! I mean, please give me a few more minutes, you're
What does it mean, you please, Mr. Payne?
The procedure is not finished yet.
What do you mean?
We would like to call our next witness to the stand. What?
And what did this witness witness?
The one with the victim was pushed to his death. That was what's more, he saw the very face of the culprit.
What the heck? Order, order in court. I believe our justice is in order. Afterward, we will hear from the new witness. I have a feeling this was... That was a bit too easy. I need more information. I have to see what I can find out through the rushes. I can't let my guard down. It's only going to get taller from here. Court is adjourned for rushes. To be continued.
Okay, guys, I think we will just end it here. Or... I think we will just end it here. Anyways, this is going to be a new adventure for us. So, thank you for watching. Leave a like, comment, and subscribe if you liked it. And I hope to see you in the next Phoenix Wright. I mean, the next video. Bye bye.